Welcome back. Pat Sims again here with Electrical Power. Previously in one of our videos, you can see the board behind me, we covered the breakdown on the cap number of an F-series breaker. That was an FA36020. You can scroll through the links there and find that video to help you determine your cap number for your breaker. But what I want to look at right now is some distinctive differences in the F frame. We broke down in the other video about the classes and the interrupting rating, but I want to look at the physical differences where you can see what's different about the breakers. In a previous video, we did the FAL, which is a lug-to-lug breaker, a lot of different configurations where you can get that with top lugs or bottom lugs or no lugs. But this particular one, hard bolts in, more obvious for this application is for motor control center buckets or standalone panels for feeders. Great breaker, good breaker frame, but on the F frame, you've also got the FA, which is in the I-line, the FA and the FC and the FH. The I-line, where it's notably different, it's the same thickness this way, but it has this crown at top and it has this foot at the bottom. The foot, obviously it's for mounting inside your panel and allows you to have a retaining screw to lock it in place once it inserts on the bus. The bus I'm speaking of is in the panel. Your connection points are here between the insulator rails, here, here, and here, but your jaws you'll see down in here, the little copper pieces, that's what intersects with the bus and the panel. So again, these guys are very similar. Same thickness this way, but you'll notice that foot, a crown atop, no crown here. So when you call in or when you check our inventory, you want to make sure that you're getting the right cap number, and the easiest way to do that is to look right here below the little square D if you have the gray label. And right below that D, there'll be a number that says cap number. That's the best way we can help you. The fastest way we can help you is that cap number to give us the proper identification for your breaker. Hopefully this helps out. As always, you can look below and use the links to go to our other resources and to our website. So guys, we appreciate you. Thanks a lot and God bless.